And here, at the Martin factory in Maryland, is a plane that may well prove an important part of that defense production. A new type of bomber ready for its tryout. They claim over there that it's the fastest bomber in the world. If that's the case, we could do with plenty of them for our ever-increasing offensive against Germany.
B-26 Marauder bombers of the 9th United States Air Force have been extremely active in operations based on Britain since their arrival here from the Middle East. People living in the south of England can scarcely have failed to notice that. Day after day, they've been attacking German airfields in France, Belgium and Holland, as well as supply dumps, secret installations and many other targets. This story, the story of a typical Marauder attack, was shot by members of a combat camera unit. And here we go. Marauder is well named. Apart from the heavy wallop it carries in its bomb racks, it's armed with 12.50 machine guns and has high speed. Coupled with the heavy poundings at night by the RAF and the brilliant work of the US heavies by day, Marauders are giving great assistance in wearing down Hitler's continental defenses. The target on this occasion was one of several airfields in Holland, from which the Germans may have been raiding London. Crews are well aware that there's bound to be plenty of flak. A radio operator makes his last contact with his base. From now on, he'll observe radio silence. Pilot and co-pilot putting on their anti-flak helmets. They know what's coming. A bombardier navigator, bombigator they call him, watches for checkpoints on the ground. And then, as the Marauders cross the enemy-held coastline, they meet the flak. Plenty of it too, as you can see, being pumped up at them from 10,000 feet below. It's a pretty hot reception they get, and this sort of thing is a daily experience. But apart from taking normal evasive action at short intervals, they fly on straight through it to their objectives. Clouds are interfering with visibility, but later the bombigator gets a clear view of his target. Any moment now it'll be bombs away. And if that airfield doesn't get a plastering, then I don't know what a plastering is. Heavy beating up, and there wasn't much the Luftwaffe could do to stop it, though a few enemy planes did attempt to take off during the attack. Not a very happy takeoff, even if any of them did leave the ground. It was after this attack that those short, sharp London raids came to an end. Not entirely a coincidence, one might think, though of course raids against us can hardly be ruled out yet. Having unloaded, the Marauders head for home at increased speed. But their worries aren't over yet. More heavy flak has to be encountered. Having flown through two sessions of flak, not to mention plenty of opposition from the ground while over the target, they positively welcome a sight of the choppy waters of the English Channel. A number of aircraft have been hit. There's one in trouble, trailing smoke as one engine cuts out. Other planes throttle down to shepherd the damaged Marauder home to base. Presently, British fighters, Typhoons, join in the job of escort. sight of their home airfield must be eminently satisfactory. And while the marauders prepare to come in and land, everything is ready down on the airfield itself. Ambulances, nurses, and medical personnel. Here comes trouble. See the flares? Hydraulic system hit. Nose wheel jammed. Landing wheels can't be locked. Well, here goes for a belly flopper. In the circumstances, a perfect landing, made incidentally by the youngest pilot of them all, age 19. Well, that's the story of just one marauder attack. But it's something that's happening pretty well every day. The Allied Supreme Commander, in the course of many recent inspections in Britain, visited units of the United States 9th Air Force. He was there when a force of marauders took off on a mission. Every day, marauders, among many other types, have been concentrating on the smashing of airfields, marshalling yards, and other transport installations, wrecking and smashing on a carefully worked out plan. A plan which is an important part of the Second Front timetable. While Germany's kept on the hop, trying to guess where Allied invasion will come, bombs go raining down at many points in Europe, disrupting Germany's defensive plan. As to the effectiveness of the bombs, judge for yourself. Although some of the targets can't be distinguished on the screen, others can. And all are properly plastered. Just one item on one day's program. But of course, it's a non-stop day and night process.
Film taken recently by the US 9th Air Force has a very different angle on war in the air. Marauders, cooperating in the reduction of the Rundstedt salient, used pathfinder technique in attacking supply centers at Wittlich, Germany. And marauders attacking a railway bridge over the Moselle ran into very heavy flak. A direct hit on a nearby plane was recorded by one of the cameramen.
Coming in on a wing and a prayer. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. Though there's one motor gone, we can still carry on. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. What a show,
what a show,
what a fight,
what a fight.
Yes, we
really hit our target for tonight, tonight.
How we'll sing as we limp through the air. Look below, there's a field over there. With our full crew aboard and our trust in the Lord. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. With our full